what's the reality of the business service center in Slovakia? You heard the keynote from Mr. Chovanec from the government perspective. Tom told us something about Poland and the more CE region. Christian outlined some challenges in Slovakia. And I'm happy that you're really using the Slido. Please throw the questions because it's important for this dialogue. I will use the opportunity and ask you, Mr. Chovanec, the first question. There is a question that it seems that the Slovakia market is really very, there is a scarcity of the resources. The market is very saturated. What is your view? What is the potential? What needs to be done from the education perspective? And I will probably add or combine two questions. Dual education seems to be not very well working for many companies because one of the threats is that the investment from the company perspective cannot be really somehow offset from the taxes and things like that. Is there anything government can do with that?
Yeah. We hear this on many different forums, and it's probably true. When with a shrinking unemployment rate, we are probably coming to the limits of available workforce. There will be the changes in the dual system, as you mentioned. If I'm correct, that should be the question directed to my colleagues from the Ministry of Education. But I think they are preparing some new legislation or how to maybe. It is shown that after 2 years of dual education in Slovakia, it needs some changes that would benefit more companies, or actually that would include it more companies to get into dual education. In general, I would say that the companies that are already cooperating with schools are achieving good results, mostly, of course, only in the industrial area, but there are also the benefits on the side of the companies. In area of services where business service center belong, I think only T-System is the only company that is working with secondary schools when doing something like a dual education. So according to my information, Ministry of Education is preparing a new legislation that would probably offset or change some of the negatives that you mentioned, that would enable more companies to join this program. Regarding the scarcity of workforce, that's again the topic that we are discussing with Ministry of Labor Affairs. There are already some plans or some new initiatives how to maybe do the or how to bring more people to the market. Maybe we need to change the way how they are when they are unemployed, how they are schooled or how they are trained to different jobs. Maybe we can introduce a. And this is my idea. It's not yet discussed with Ministry of Labor Affairs. Maybe we should find a program where companies would be paid when they would train their own employee that used to be, or their own future employee that used to be unemployed before. Or we can maybe find the new ways of employment. For example, the work from home is one of the areas where that is not yet covered well in our legislation. So I think, and it's not only because of business service centers, but because of the industrial companies, we need to come up with new mechanisms and new instruments how to bring more people to the market. But maybe last comment, business service centers have the better position comparing to some industrial companies because they are able to recruit workforce directly from the universities and grammar schools. So it's a little easier for you, but that should not mean that we are not going to implement also this services sector into new instruments.
Thank you very much. Tom, there is a question for you. What is so attractive for the companies to come to Poland? And I would add another question. 2 to 4% unemployment in a cities or Polish cities, isn't it a threat for the companies? And what the government or city municipalities are doing to really somehow encourage them positively motivate companies to go to other places where probably unemployment is a little bit higher?
Yeah, maybe it's also the kind of that first question, second question there now, examples of companies leaving. And one thing we've seen is that in Krakow, for example, which is so popular and so big for this sector, some of them are leaving, but some of them are not leaving where you think. State Street, for example, has maybe 2,000 employees in Krakow. They're not leaving Krakow, but they're expanding into Gdańsk in the north of Poland. not to India, not somewhere else. So sometimes when the idea of that someone's leaving or moving east, they might move to eastern Slovakia or eastern Poland, not to India. So we're seeing that already where, yes, some of those jobs might be shifted. The companies in whole are not leaving, but those simple jobs might be shifted to a Kielce or to a Rzeszów or Białystok in Poland, eastern Poland, where there is higher unemployment and a lot lower cost. But those are typically the most simple processes. The other thing is that we're seeing that some of the companies are taking their most simple processes and outsourcing them to a BPO company. So an Accenture, IBM, Capgemini says, you know, to Christian, we can you give us your most simple things that are your most dumbed down processes now that add no value? And yes, take these 15 jobs, and that begins a process of moving those more simple jobs outside. But I think what also in Poland you're seeing is that, yes, there's the smaller cities now are seeing much bigger opportunities, which was not the case 5 years ago. So they're fighting to make sure they got a good airport in the city, making sure that they have good regulations, making sure they have offices ready to go. That's a big issue because the guys are not going to move in unless they've got an office ready, to your point of spec offices or not. So, but leaving entirely Poland, we haven't really seen it. There are maybe some cases, but there's no data that would suggest it's anything significant at this stage.
Okay, thank you. Mr. State Secretary mentioned that T-Systems is one of the company or only company using dual education, but I think that there are more examples how companies cooperate with the academia. Christian, any thoughts or any examples you have in your company or you can share with us?
Yeah, we are trying to increase the cooperation with academia, especially in the sector of soft skills, mm-hmm. because what we see and you refer to it, it's a question how fast fresh graduates are ready to take over the job. One part is the process-related skill set, and we can say that let's put it this way, the technical education in Slovakia is on a very high level. So we don't have an issue with this. But where we see a need, which is also addressed by the activities of BSCF, is to upgrade the skill set in terms of soft skill, which we get from, which is the basic level we get from fresh graduates. And here, for the time being, the scale of activities we are able to reach or to initiate as industry is too low. This means here we require a multiplicator. We require scale, not doing it, doing a lot of sessions for, let's say, batteries of 50 people, 25 people, 30 people. We have to integrate this in the basic studies. Mm-hmm.
And you think that this is an opportunity for the universities and high schools to really be open, a little more open to business?
Of course it is. And I think it's maybe we are addressing this as our industry, but these skills are required in any industry. So it's a good development to integrate it into studies for all sectors.
Thank you. Mr. Kovanec, you addressed that in your keynote that there are a lot of activities which are really being addressed in action plan. One of them is a foreign law or a law for intercompany transfers, which is currently being a little bit stuck because of some additional requirements or disputes between Ministry of Finance and Ministry of Interior. Not related to business service sector. Yes, thank you. But and it will be, hopefully, if everything goes well, because it's a transposition of the European Union legislation into Slovakia framework, hopefully it will be in place by April. But Christian touched that also, Tom really mentioned that short-term fix for the skill set shortage on the market seems to be flexibility on highly skilled employees or highly skilled candidates being brought from the third countries, right, outside of the European Union. Is there anything Ministry of Economy is thinking or Ministry of Economy can really help with?
We can start a discussion with Ministry of Labor Affairs regarding this. You know, it's a very, very sensitive topic in general about bringing some people from third countries to Slovakia. I think there will be some areas where my colleagues from the Ministry of Labor Affairs will probably be willing to listen to some of the arguments by the companies that are affected by this shortage of people. I think that we still have some room also to maybe bring the people that are already in Slovakia and the young ones that are unemployed, to bring them to the labor market and maybe do some specific program for them regarding the possibility to find a job in business service centers. Now I'm talking about the areas where it's very high youth unemployment. So it will not be done within the weeks, but I think by the end of the year we will have a good plan, or we will have a knowledge if there will be some possibilities to bring on a short-term basis the people from third countries, maybe to wait or to offset the shortage of people.
Okay, Tom, how important this is for Poland, and how this is being addressed from the Polish government, if at all?
You mean the labor side of things?
I mean the skilled workforce labor from third countries or countries outside of the European Union.
One issue was a big issue last year, which got some lobbying from ABSL organization, was the for the money laundering financial companies. There was a question of the so-called vetting of that, and the Polish law was much more strict and was making it more difficult to hire people inside financial companies. And I think that has been diminished or weakened somehow, so that they're able to do that more. I'm not sure how much, but that was an issue that got a lot of, let's say, lobbying attention from the shared services sector. And I know that the government has listened to that, and I think they've made some specific changes to that, because I don't hear about it anymore. But I don't know precisely how far they've gone, but that's certainly been an issue and has been improved.
Thank you. Christian, a little bit challenging question. There is a question on the slide, though, that in Slovak statistic there are about 40,000 university-educated employees or graduates unemployed in Slovakia. Why they cannot work in a business service centers? What is your experience recruiting people, and why you believe, or why we believe, in a business service center that we have already hitting the limit? So can you please give us some real-life examples?
I can do. First question back would be, where are the 40,000? I would say the least of them are in the Bratislava area, and you already referred to this point. I think we have to see the geographical differences in Slovakia in terms of unemployment. Looking at the concrete situation in Bratislava, based on the experience we have, one very important topic are language skills. And Gabriel, you pointed it out already in your intro speech. It's not about speaking English. That's a prerequisite. Uh-huh. It's about mostly speaking a second, ideally even a third, foreign language. And if we see the situation on the labor market, we see an increasing trend of open positions. If we analyze this a little bit more in detail, we see an increasing trend of open positions with specific language skills. Means I don't know about the specific skill sets of the 40,000, but what I see in the market is that we are obviously not very successful to staff such positions which have a more complex profile, on one side looking at the technical skill set in combination with language skill set. And this is, once again, coming to the point, it's important to address the topic of languages, because we have to be aware whatever we are doing in terms of education will help us. If we trigger it now, it will help us in some years. Maybe, if you allow me, one short comment regarding the immigration.
Sure, go ahead.
Out of my understanding, it's very important that we fix this challenge as soon as possible. As Tom, you also pointed out, we are now in very interesting times. There are big opportunities ahead in terms of what is called robotic process automation. most of the companies are now starting intensively to work on the topics. Most of headquarters are doing now allocation decisions where to place these activities. If we, and I mentioned it in my short presentation, as being internally competing also with other locations within our corporations, if we are not able to prove that we can attract those candidates with the necessary skill sets from Slovakia or from abroad, then we may have a competitive disadvantage. And these are the decisions which are made now, next year, maybe also in 2018.
Sure. And you named it very correctly, but there is a gap or misunderstanding that we really have to think about in more details, because on one hand, if there is a shortage of people and the easy solution is to bring people from abroad, which it is, and then the next question is, or the next comment is, that we have 40,000 university educated people that we are not able to bring into the process, there is a structural problem somewhere in between. The question is that out of these 40,000 people, what university they finished, or what is their major? You know, what can they actually do? It might be real, or it might be true that most of them do not even speak sufficient English language, which is then a question on why they went to university and how they were able to receive the diploma. I think we should look at this. It's a problem. I will not be politically correct. It's a problem. We should look at this in a maybe innovative way, because there are some other instruments or some other projects that probably have to be implemented very quickly. And one is the initiative that also I think Business Service Central Forum does have with ITAS, that's the Slovak IT Association. Oh, hello, didn't see you there, sorry. See, I'm doing you a PR without even knowing you are here. And it combines two things. One is that business service centers can say exactly how the profile of the new employee should look like, and what additional education or training he or she should receive within the maybe short period of time. I'm talking about something like a boot camps, 2-3 months intensive period on the training in a very specific activities that they will be able to get the job right away. And these are the programs that are working abroad. These are the programs that can be also paid by the European structural funds. And this is something that we should probably find a way how to start them or finance them immediately, because these people are on the market. Maybe we cannot target them. Maybe they are not well educated. Maybe they are not getting the right training from the labor office. I don't know. I don't want to speculate. But here are the instruments that can, within, well, as I said, 3-6 months period, bring a lot of people to you to be available for as your next employees. So the new situation with a very low unemployment and basically missing some amount of employees will probably lead us to introducing these new innovative techniques or new ways, new programs that would attract the additional people to also this industry.
And I would say, if I can add as well, that I think that the private sector is going to find the solutions as well. Mm-hmm. We can't pile everything onto the government and say, please do this, this, and this, fix all of our problems. I don't know what the budget you guys have inside your company for training soft skills, but for sure you would spend some money on training, soft skill training or language training. And we're seeing companies also that have sprung up that say, I am a soft skills training company, that's all we do. And another one that is a intensive language, like a 2-week language. And they promise they can get someone learning German in a conversation level within 2 weeks. So those kind of things are, you know, leaving aside whether that's a trick or not trick, let's say it works. Those are the kind of solutions that I suppose a service center like you guys would invest in. Yeah.
Well, exactly, but it has been really mentioned in all three presentations that we need to continuously invest, right? Because the industry evolves, the technology evolves, so we cannot really start sleeping. We need to continuously invest as an employer, right? Mr. Chovan has addressed that the shortage of the skills is how quickly they can start really do the job, right? So is it 6 months or could it be shortened to 2 months? And can it be offset by maybe last or 6 months or last semester at the university or maybe at the high school? But that's something which hopefully those two gentlemen I mentioned at the beginning, being part of the educational reform will help us address in a new program. There is a question from the audience, and because the question about the 40,000 employees was anonymous, it's a request from the Business Service Center Forum leadership. Give us more statistics, give us more information, as Christian mentioned, give us the information about where they're geographically located, what skill set they have, and we'll certainly look at how we can really incorporate them, because Christian also addressed that there is continuously increased number of open positions which we cannot fill, maybe because of the specific skill set, maybe because of the specific language requirement, maybe we can find something with the Ministry of Labor and Social Affairs, some programs, and really quickly educate them. Maybe ITAS can help us with the academia, the type of concept, so there are some solutions.
I have one more idea, and I briefly mentioned it during my speech, that maybe we should do more marketing about the work at the business service centers, because for a lot of young people it might sound boring and it might sound that it's not interesting, which is not true anymore, because the activities that are there are much more sophisticated than it was before. The business service center could be those very sophisticated modern factories of 21st century, and in June there will be 30,000-40,000 kids getting out of the school anyway. So if we, and now we have 6 month period, where if we can make this industry or environment or the sector interesting for them, it would be much easier for you to target those people. As I said, it should not be like last chance, okay, I didn't find another job, yeah, I will go to work in the business, etc. It doesn't work like that anymore, because those are very highly professional jobs that you are offering. So, and that's probably a question to both of us or to all of us. This is very easy way how to actually attract a lot of people from the market right away that are coming out of the schools.
Absolutely. There is another question for you, Mr. Hohen.
For me?
The question is, financing basic education or initial education, you will get only the skills which are needed for the entire life, right? So the initial skills. Can that be changed, right? So I guess that the question is more going into a direction. Basic is good foundation, but how about the next level?
I'm not sure I really understand what
is Mr. Schilhar somewhere here.
What do you mean by this?
Yeah, it's over.
I have no voice. In Slovakia, there is a fantasy.
Can you please wait for a mic? It will help you with your voice.
Sorry for my voice. In Slovakia, we are financing just initial education, and there is no systematic tool or support of further education. So it means like you get all the required skills for all your life at school, and then it is stopped. So I don't think it's realistic to function in 21st century like this. So what do you think about this from your position?
Okay, so you mean like everybody once in 5 years should go back to school for 6 months? Maybe?
No, there are many different examples from different countries how the further education can be financed.
It's a good question. Probably it needs more thinking. I think we have big enough problems in the initial education right now. But what I think it's maybe for the future more important that the students will get out of the schools with much better knowledge of these soft skills. Because if you would sit here 10, 15 years ago, we would actually not sit here, because there was not a sector in Slovakia or not a business service center platform yet. And that's what I mean, that within the world and with the globalization is changing and the new technologies is changing so quickly that maybe not even you have idea what kind of what do you will need from your employees in 5 years. So it's very difficult to ask the schools that they should be available or to open the program that in 5 years will get you the available workforce. I think what
the role of schools will be that they should prepare the kids that are easily trained, so they are very open-minded, they are flexible, they know how to solve the basic problems, they know languages, they have these soft skills, and then each employer will actually train them or teach them to work at the position, because these people will change the positions each 2, 3, 5 years. It's not like our parents or my parents that they had one job or one in one company for the whole life. So I think it's much easier to have like this open-minded people or people that can adapt to the new jobs, and then it will be up to the specific industry or companies to train them for the activities that they really need.
Yeah, continuous education is probably it's a must, right? As I addressed in my opening speech, English is a must. We expect that, as you rightly said, the technology evolves and everything. Tom, according to your experience, what is the most effective way how to attract candidates considering high competitive environment in business service center sector?
Well, I hope, Gabriel, you're going to let me talk about Trump later on, because that came up as well. Any conversation about Trump is interesting, so we'll come back to Trump in a second. I think we touched on that a few minutes ago. I think it's multiple things. It's letting them know, it's job fairs, it's portals for shared service center employees, it's multiple things that can be done by different people to show that it's actually a pretty cool place to work inside a shared service center. I mean, these are world-class offices. They have incredible furniture. A lot of them have free delivery of food, fresh fruit every day. I mean, they are treated in some ways like kings and queens inside of these centers. That message needs to get out. Further beyond that, they're also working in a really international environment. They're talking, speaking English, German, French, whatever, all across the globe, all day long. It's a very interesting environment. And I think for a 25, 30-year-old, I think it's one of the best places that one could be working. I think that message is getting out. It just needs another push. But I think the direction is getting there. It just needs another push and a continual reminder of that going on. And the employer branding thing is also going on, where the employers are saying, let's have a little video of what we're doing, make sure the message gets out that you know, this company is really a cool, interesting place to work.
Thank you very much, Tom. And as Mr. Hovan has mentioned, there are a lot of talks in the public media about the startups and things like that, but there is very little discussion about the shared services, right? What we are doing, how great offices and the facilities we are. Mr. Hovanes, I will probably close with the last question. Our prime minister is always seen in the media, in the manufacturing companies. When we can expect him to visit any of the shared service centers?
Do we have any media people here in the room? So I will answer off record this question if you allow me. By the way, I love answering anonymous questions. That's really great. Actually, the answer to this question was already said a few minutes ago. If we can make this sector more visible, mm-hmm. it would of course attract also the top politicians in our country, because if they would realize that there is 40,000 people, which is by the way more than in the financial sector, more in the, or maybe at the same level of the electrotechnical industry sector, which are viewed by the public and by the politicians as very important, which they are, but do not forget about this. So as soon as we are able to show that this sector has a huge potential and employs a lot of people, I think it will turn attention also of the politicians, but I'm not going to promise it, but my goal is that I will convince the Prime Minister and his team that they would visit one or two of these biggest centers in Slovakia within the next 6 months.
Thank you very much. We take it as a public commitment from you. Well, I would say we convince you, we convince Ministry of Economy, your minister or your boss, if I can use the terminology from the business, is convinced that the business service sector is a good industry. It's an industry which really deserves the focus and the attention. We have a room for the last question, and I saw Marian Lelowski from ITAS waving on me. So Marian, the stage is yours.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen, hello, good morning. Let me first of all congratulate my friend Gabriel and his team for organizing such a great conference. I am really happy to see you all there. So it shows that the strength of business service centers is growing. IT Association of Slovakia is a little bit older than you. We have been mentioned here twice, and we have been mentioned as a supporter of your association or forum. So we are here for 20 years. We are representing about 45,000 employees, and you are not anymore a small child, but you are growing very fast, even faster than our sector. And I really welcome you here on board, where we would like to change Slovakia from industrial country to the modern service-oriented country. And I also welcome your activities, and please go together with us to Ministry of Education, Ministry of Labor, Ministry of Economy, and we need to fight with them. It's about 5 years now for fight, which is in every sector you have been mentioning here, or every activity. I have been twice within last 6 weeks, I have been twice in Ukraine, so I have some experience what's going on there, and we have to really be fast. So congratulations and go on.
Thank you very much. It's very encouraging. I would like to say that I'm really happy that on this second conference already we have representatives from the, advisory body to Ministry of Education, because I was told that I should not be announcing them as a Ministry of Education, because they are not the Ministry of Education employees. We see support from the Ministry of Economy, which is really big support and really big advocate of the Business Service Center. We see support from academia world. Many people from the high school and universities are here. Many people from the business are here. Also, there is a lot of interest. We see that there is a media team. It's our media team. We will try to create short presentation video from this conference, which we will put on our web pages, and we will try to promote that. Mr. Hovan.
I just wanted to react. Please don't fight with us. We really want to help you. Too many people are fighting with us anyway.
We will be less radical, and we will be cooperating with you, and we will find the mutual grounds there.
We are ready.
Thank you very much for our panelists, State Secretary of the Ministry of Economy, Mr. Rastislav Chovanec.
Thank you.
Christian Schulz, head of SSC Henkel Slovakia.
Yeah.
And Tom Barnhart, founder of the Business Polska, coming to this stage and discussing with us. Hopefully.
Okay, thanks.
Thank you. Hopefully you enjoy the information. Hopefully you get some ideas what is going on. It's not that bad, don't worry. Don't really start thinking about refreshing your CV and really finding a new job. There is some positive encouragement at the end of the day. Next encouragement for you is a half an hour coffee break, but we expect you within 30 minutes back in the room, and we'll be talking about education and about the skill set which is required for being successful in Business Service Center. Have a good fun, and back in 30 minutes.